Here's a question we get a lot. Is the Shapeoko accurate enough for my project? The answer is yes. Thanks for watching. Okay, just kidding. The answer is still probably yes, but let's explore this idea some more. We all know CNC machines are great for being able to make cuts more repeatably or accurately than the average Mark I human, but for really complicated tasks, just how precise is a benchtop CNC like the Shapeoko 5 Pro? Before we look at how accurate the machine can be though, it's worth flipping the question. What degree of precision do you need? How complex are your projects? Because for the right price, there are machines out there that can move individual atoms, but no sane person needs that capability. If you're cutting out a single part project, like a tray or even a big 3D carving, your biggest concern will probably be that the finished piece be of high quality with smooth, clean edges. If you're cutting out parts that need to fit together, like for furniture or inlays, you're going to need to hit the same tolerances a carpenter does, the width of a pencil line. If you're cutting out small parts like a coin, the height of design features like text usually imposes a non-negotiable requirement on resolution. And in short, we have all those capabilities covered. But the point I'm trying to get at is, I can give you a number that describes the accuracy of a machine. It's just a line on a spec sheet. But people don't see numbers, they see results. And so to really understand what the Shapeoko is made of, we have to push it to its limits. So let's go have some fun. I'll be running some tests on the 4x4-foot Shapeoko 5 Pro CNC router we have here in the shop. This is a ball screw-driven machine that's meant to be the best balance of versatility, capability, and value offered by Carbide 3D. In a video we published a few weeks ago, we showed a glimpse of the performance of this machine platform by turning a block of aluminum into spicy glitter. But having ample raw power on tap doesn't always translate to finesse. So let's do some empirical testing to see just how precisely the Shapeoko can move. I'm going to set up an engraving test here on the same size piece of aluminum we previously machined. This makes it easy for me to mill the face of the block to get it perfectly level. This is important because it guarantees the depth of our engravings will be consistent. The design we're going to engrave is a sequence of text that gets progressively smaller and smaller. We'll see at what point it ceases to be legible. The tool we're going to use is an engraving bit with a 0.1mm diameter tip, about 0.004 of an inch or one sheet of paper thick. It's the sharpest thing I could find in the shop, and it's beyond what most reasonable people will ever need. The first engraving test is creating text 12mm tall. That's just shy of half an inch in freedom units. Here, we need no magnification to see that it works. This is a piece of cake. We've already got examples of projects smaller than this on our channel, so consider this a control test in our experiment. Now, in full disclosure, there is a little bit of a burr being raised here. I didn't take enough time to get my settings dialed in, but we can easily knock that burr down with a surfacing pass and some fine grit sandpaper later. Let's tighten up the framing of the camera and keep going with this experiment. This is now a 6mm tall engraving, or roughly a quarter inch. Again, the machine is easily defining all the details in the letters needed to make them legible. Piece of cake. Let's zoom in again. Now we're down to 3mm, roughly an eighth of an inch. This is usually about the degree of precision people are looking for when engraving things like plaques or larger coins. The desired details are still very obviously present, so let's focus over here on the left and go again. Here, we're going to engrave 1.5mm tall text. Even with a slow, conservative feed rate, this is going by pretty quick. The burr raised does somewhat obscure the text, but you can still make out the intent of the machine when running this program. Let's punch in again. 0.8mm, that's how tall this text is. We are now at the level of detail that my camera with a macro filter is having trouble capturing. It appears to be working, but we'll need to do a little bit of cleanup to verify that. I would like to point out that this is already beyond what the average adult can read unassisted. No normal person needs to machine something this fine, but it is fun. And since we've come this far, we might as well shoot for the stars. Let's enhance the image one more time, just for the heck of it. And this is the first result that doesn't look all that promising, an attempted engraving at 0.4mm tall. Oh well, I was asking a lot of not just the Shapeoko, but the tool. This just might be the limit. Or is it? For now, let's go ahead and clean up the engravings by running a surfacing pass to shear off any burrs. you can see immediately that the engravings are dramatically improved just from that. Let's get a closer look, focusing in on the bottom since we know the larger engravings came out fine. You can see the details on even the 0.8mm tall engravings are quite legible. Here's a penny for scale, since I couldn't fit a banana in frame. And here's the attempted 0.4mm engraving hiding under a mechanical pencil lead. You can't really see much, so let me lap the surface on some 1000 grit sandpaper and get this under the microscope. With this view, the 0.8mm now looks as clear as our 12mm engraving did on camera, and it actually looks like the Shapeoko gave the 0.4mm text a solid effort. Remember, I was using a 0.1mm engraver. This text is nominally 0.4mm tall. It's the CNC equivalent of trying to sign your name on a check with a fat Sharpie. If you spaced out the letters just a little more, you'd get a result like this. And that period after the first enhance test run, that was me trying to engrave the Carbide 3D logo at the same scale. And it actually kind of worked. Like, the only way I could possibly top this is if I engraved on a mechanical pencil lead. But, you know, let's not... Okay, you know what? Let's just give it a shot. I've machined some tiny features in my aluminum block to capture the graphite stick, and I'm going to use some adhesive to hold it in place. The results are... well, I think they speak for themselves. By the way, in case you're looking at these results thinking, pfft, they're doing all these accuracy tests without any load on the spindle, I did my engravings on an elevated stump of material that I machined around the perimeter of. The measurements of this raised area are within 1/1000th of an inch of the dimensions they're supposed to be. That's using a 1/2 inch end mill and a full depth 3/4 inch finishing pass. I did not go easy on the Shapeoko. To be honest, doing these tests exceeded my own personal expectations. I know the theoretical resolution of the machine is even smaller than the minimum text size I chose, but seeing the Shapeoko actually executing these test programs as intended is something I found oddly satisfying. It's a testament to the quality of the linear motion components put into the machine. It's hard to convey just how ridiculously fine these engraving tests are. They defy most common senses of scale. But I hope I've convinced you that the Shapeoko 5 Pro is more than accurate enough and absolutely qualified to handle any relief carvings, inlay work, or whatever else you could ask of a CNC router. Good luck and have fun machining, folks! This is Winston for Carbide 3D signing off.